colleagues, welcome back in the third video of second chapter of geography. Dear students, yesterday we studied about land, we discussed about soil, factors to soil formation, and we studied about few more measures. With the help of those measures, how soil can be conserved. Dear students, today we are going to study about water. My dear students, let us come to know about water. Water is vital, renewable, natural resource. My dear students, you might have seen already, water is vital and renewable resource. This resource can be renewed again and again. My dear students, if you see the total amount of water on the earth, it is 71%. It means 71% of the earth is filled with water and 29% of the earth is within landmass. That is why it is appropriately said water planet, because of 71% it is covered with water. That is why we call it water planet. My dear students, if you see the total percentage of saline water and fresh water, the entire 71% of the water is not fit for human consumption, because amount of water is saline, not fit for the human consumption. Let us come to know, my dear students, let us see how much percent water is fresh water available on the earth. You might have seen earlier also that 2.7% water is fresh water on the earth. Rest water, it means 97.3% water is saline. It means this water is not fit for human consumption. And the water which is 2.7%, which we call is fresh water, it is found in the ice caps, rivers, lakes, in Antarctica, Greenland, in these areas where it is inaccessible. Only this much water is fresh water on the earth. My dear students, you can imagine that a very less percent of water is fresh water on the earth. As you have seen in your previous class also, in India, how much water is required for a person per day? 135 liter water is required for per person in urban areas. How much percent water? 135 liter water is required in urban areas. Not only for drinking purpose, not only for cooking food, for various purpose, for washing clothes, for washing the utensils, flushings, for taking baths, for several purposes water is required. Dear friends, now you can understand the value of fresh water on the earth. You might be knowing that this 135 liter water, which is used by an average person in the urban area, is sufficient or no. Now, if you see the percentage of water which is fresh from the earth is very less, only 2.7%. My dear students, now we will discuss that this water which is saline is not fit many countries are there in the world which are facing the water scarcity. Even this water, which is fresh, is used for agriculture, for industries. What do? They pollute the water. And you might know many rivers in India like Ganga, Yamuna. These rivers are mostly polluted rivers nowadays in India. Dear students, now we will discuss the availability of water. Let us come to know the second point here. Availability of fresh water. As I have just told you, the availability of fresh water is available in the ice lakes, or you can say glaciers, rivers, underground water, These are the sources from where we get fresh water, which is fit for the human consumption. Now let us come to know problems of water availability. Second point, problems of water availability. My dear friends, if you see around the world today, many countries are there which are facing water scarcity, means shortage of water. Let us come to know which are the countries which are facing water scarcity. Dear students, South Asia, West Asia, Australia, parts of America, South Africa, parts of Mexico, these are the countries which are facing water scarcity today, even including India. If you write India also here, it won't be wrong. Because my dear students, if you see some parts of India like Rajasthan, there is a great problem in this state. Not only Rajasthan, if you talk about Gujarat and Maharashtra, these are the states which are facing water scarcity today. And dear students, if we human beings will not be aware about the water conservation, then these countries will be facing water scarcity today. My dear students, if you see some parts of India like Thar desert in Rajasthan, it is very difficult to find out water in this area. Have you ever heard about water market? If you see Saurashtra, which is in Gujarat, there is a place which accounts 1.25 lakh population, which completely depend upon the water market. They purchase the water every day for drinking purpose. So now you can understand the problem of water scarcity. Dear students, it depends upon the density of rainfall also. Some countries are there in the world which has very less rainfall. Even in the same way, Rajasthan, it receives very less rainfall. Some of the areas are there of India which receives only 10 cm to 20 cm rainfall annually, which is very, very less. And now we will discuss methods of water conservation. My dear friends, it is very much important for us to conserve the water. Otherwise, this dwindling resource will be adjusted. neither be subtracted from the earth, because it remains constant, it remains same. Now, let us understand methods of water conservation. It is very, very important for us. Let us discuss one by one all the methods. My dear students, see, rainwater harvesting. Of rainwater harvesting. Water. This technique is not new. This technique is very old. Many parts are there of the country where people make their terraces in such a way so that they can collect rain water. We might have seen what people do. Suppose this is house. In this house, the terrace of the house is meant in such a way that during the time of rainfall, these people can conserve this water, the terrace. And later on, with the help of pipeline, people use this pipeline, and with the help of this pipeline, they store this water in the tank or abandoned well, you can say. This is the method which is very essential, very important in countries like India. Let me tell you an interesting fact for you. That Tamil Nadu is the only one state in India where government of Tamil Nadu made very compulsory for each and every house of Tamil Nadu to make their terrace in such a way so that they can collect rainwater. Government takes action against the defaulters. Why not we adopt this method? They also see rainfall, and even you might be knowing Cherrapunji, Mousin Rao. These are the places which receive highest rainfall in all over the world. But then also, the state Meghalaya received this much rainfall, but then also they received water scarcity problem, especially in the capital city, which is not so far away from Mousin Rao or the Cherrapunji. Now, the next thing which we are going to discuss, drip or trickle irrigation. My dear friends, irrigation is very essential for farming activities, especially in the dry region areas. This method is very suitable, this method is very helpful. Drip irrigation is adopted. If you get a chance to go to Rajasthan, you will see farmers of Rajasthan have adopted drip irrigation, or the triple, you can say trickle irrigation. With the help of this trickle irrigation, they irrigate their fields. Now, we thought we can discuss rooftop rainwater harvesting. As we have discussed, states like Rajasthan is very conscious about this, is very much aware about this method. They also conserve the water under this system. Next is the backward drip irrigation. Dear students, this method is very helpful and it is already adopted in eastern states of India, northeastern states of India like Assam, Meghalaya, Arunachal Pradesh. These states of India, farmers, they cut the bamboos into the two parts, they connect these with each other, and during the time of rain, they collect the water. So my dear students, we need to take some serious steps. We need to be very much aware about these methods, then only water can be conserved. Otherwise, it will not be easy for us to conserve the water. Other things which we need to take care in our daily life. Suppose whenever you see the water tank, if it is on without any reason, you need to switch off it. You need to off it. Then only we can conserve the water. Unnecessarily, we should not draw the water. We should not, you can say, we should not overuse the water. So these are the methods. By using these methods, we can every year, only one single day. This wastes 1200 liters water. Now you can imagine, you can think if several number of taps are leaking, we need to change it. Otherwise, this wastage of water will continuously take place. So I hope that each and every one of you will be very much aware about water conservation. This is about water, availability of water, and problems of water availability. Then we discuss about water conservation. Now let us move to the next step, and the next step is natural vegetation and wildlife resources. Dear students, I hope that you have already studied in your previous class about natural vegetation. It is very important, very essential for us to know about natural vegetation. Even the chapter was in class 7 also about natural vegetation and wildlife resources. Dear students, now let me have to discuss something with you about natural vegetation. All the trees, herbs, shrubs, plants that grows without the help of the human being or without the interference of the human being is known as natural vegetation. Dear students, here we will discuss definition of natural vegetation, distribution of natural vegetation, and we will also discuss conservation of natural vegetation and wildlife resources. Now, let us come to the point. The thing which we are going to discuss is natural vegetation. What is natural vegetation? All the trees, plants, herbs, and shrubs that grows without the help of the human being or without the interference of the human being is known as natural vegetation. There are different types of natural vegetation: forests, shrubs, bushes. Last year also we had studied about natural vegetation and its types. Now we will discuss about natural vegetation. If you see in your area around you, there are different kind of trees out there. If you go to the another area, you will see different kind of trees there. Why it is so? Dear students, natural vegetation changes because of temperature, moisture, climate, availability of soil. These factors play a very important role for the availability of the natural vegetation. Dear students, if you get a chance to visit in the mountain areas, you will see different kind of deodar, cheam, pine trees. And if you go to the tropical evergreen forest areas, you will see mahogany, ebony, rosewood trees. And if you see the deciduous areas, you will see neem, shisham, kikar, different kind of trees here. And if you get a chance to visit in the desert of Rajasthan, which are dry areas, there you will see different kind of bushes, cactus. These are the common trees which are found in these areas. That is why natural vegetation depends on the two factors, that is temperature and secondly moisture, or you can say even rainfall also. So these are the two important factors. These are the two important factors which are helpful for the natural vegetation. Dear students, natural vegetations are the wealth for our life. We get a lot of things from the natural vegetation. We get papers, oxygen we breathe, fruits, latex, honey, different things we get in our life, which is very useful for us. Now, dear students, let us hear about ecosystem. What is ecosystem? The life supporting system. The life supporting system is known as ecosystem. In this system, all the living things are interrelated with each other and interconnected with each other. My dear students, in this system, from a very small thing to a very big thing plays a very, very important role. This is the importance of natural vegetation. Dear students, now we will discuss distribution of natural vegetation. Distribution of natural vegetation. Dear students, let us have a discussion about distribution of natural vegetation. Distribution is depend on the areas, availability of soil, temperature. If you see the categories of the natural vegetation are of two types. One is of tropical evergreen. Tropical evergreen first. And second is tropical deciduous forest. Tropical evergreen forest do not shed their leaves at the particular times of the year. Tropical deciduous forest shed their leaves at the different times of the year. Dear students, tropical evergreen forests are found in those areas which receive high rainfall, like western part of India, West Bengal, Andaman Nicobar. These are the areas of India which receive high rainfall, especially eastern part of India. There we can see tropical evergreen forests. These forests are evergreen throughout the year. That is why we call them evergreen forests. Next is tropical deciduous forests. These forests are known as monsoon forests also. These are found in those areas, the areas which receive moderate to high rainfall, like Uttar Pradesh, Haryana, Punjab, Maharashtra, some part of Deccan Plateau, these are the areas where we could see tropical deciduous forest areas. My dear students, now we will have a discussion about conservation of natural vegetation and about wildlife also. Now let us come to know about wildlife resources. As the word says, wildlife, it talks about the life of animals. It talks about animals, insects and aquatic life. Let me tell you, it involves different animals, insects and aquatic life. Dear friends, this plays very important role in our life. We get milk from them, we get wool from them. Insects also plays a very important role for the pollination of flowers, especially insects like bees, we get honey from them, and aquatic life also plays a very important role in the ecosystem. Dear students, now we will have a discussion of conservation of natural vegetation and wildlife. Before we go to the conservation, let us see how these resources are going to be endangered, going to be extinct, vulnerable today. Let us see. Dear students, as you know, development is taking place all over the world. Industries are set up, factories are set up, and that is the reason these trees are becoming less and it is affecting the wildlife also. Nowadays, because of poaching, which is an illegal activity where poachers poach the skins of animals, bones of animals, even the teeth of animals, feathers of the birds, they sell it in the market by illegal way. We need to stop it. This can be done through spreading the awareness. We need to bring awareness among the public, especially the school children can be taught in such a way so that they can give much encouragement or appreciation towards the wildlife resources. Dear students, Government of India have taken lot of steps for the conservation of natural resources and wildlife. Now let us see conservation of natural resources and wildlife resources. Dear students, this is very important in our life. If we need to maintain this beautiful planet, then we have to conserve all the wildlife resources. See, have a discussion about the conservation. Let us see. This first, which is very important thing, is awareness. Awareness programs we need to initiate, then only we can conserve the plants and trees, especially during the time of the World Environment Day, which is known as One Mahotsav program. During this One Mahotsav program, we need to plant trees every year. And dear students, Government of India have taken a lot of steps. There are different kind of national parks are here, which are set up by Government of India, national parks, wildlife sanctuaries, these are established by Government of India. Around 89 national parks are there in the country and different wildlife sanctuaries are there. Even 14 biosphere reserves are there in India. You might be knowing, which are very famous in India. Nanda Devi National Park is there, Jeev Karkot National Park, Dudhwa National Park, Kanha National Park, Rajivandi National Park, Jeev Karkot National Park, different wildlife sanctuaries, the wildlife sanctuary is there, Periyar Biosphere Reserve is there in India. So my dear students, there are different steps are there, different national parks are there, different wildlife sanctuaries are there, which are the protection for wildlife and animals, which is very, very essential, very important. Nowadays, the next important thing is that different governments in the different country of India or different parts of the world have introduced new programs. Like you see, in India, Wildlife Protection Act, Wildlife Protection Act have been introduced by Government of India 1972-1973. What is done? According to this act, we cannot kill any animals like tiger, rhinoceros, leopards. We can't even kill peacock also. So these are the steps which has been taken by Government of India. Different projects are there. Project Tiger, Project Rhinoceros, Project Elephants. These are also the scheme which has been initiated by Government of India. So dear students, being a citizen of the nation, it is our ethical duty to protect these animals and as well as birds. Science is an agreement between the government which gives protection for the different kind of Convention on International Trade in Endangered Endangered Species. This is a scheme which has been initiated with the agreement of the different governments in the different countries. Under this act, its aim to protect 5,000 species of animals and 28,000 species of different kind of plants. Dear students, this is the end of the chapter number 2 of geography, land, soil, water, natural vegetation and wildlife. In today's video number 3, we discuss about water, which is one of the vital renewable resource. We discussed about availability of water, scarcity of water, water conservation. After this, we discuss about natural vegetation, what is natural vegetation, distribution of natural vegetation, and about the wildlife resources we discussed. We discussed conservation of natural vegetation and wildlife resources, the steps has been taken by Government of India. Dear students, if any doubt is there from this chapter, if any queries are there from this chapter, you can leave comments or you can leave a question for your answer. Dear students, the notes of this chapter will be sent to you through PDF. Thank you. Have a good day. Bye-bye.